the second you walk into the clubhouse, it's a different feel.
The Mariners have rallied to take the lead.
Mitch Haniger has done it again.
Kiss this one goodbye.
Holy smokes.
Dean Segura's having a spectacular year.
The West Coast version of Murderer's Row right now. These guys are doing it.
Something special happening out in Seattle.
The offense is a big reason why, and pleased to be joined now by current hitting coach for the Seattle Mariners, Edgar Martinez, here with Eric Burns. So we've moved over here to the place what we call the skybox. That's, as I said, a little hitter, master's class in hitting here. Burnsy, when you looked at Edgar Martinez and getting ready for this segment, going over through tapes, what stood out to you at the way he operated at the plate?
What's funny is that there's actually a tape that was put together. And I didn't have to see any tape on Edgar because I'd watched so much tape of him in the past. So in the offseason, I had a full-blown Edgar Martinez hit tape where I had every one of your hits that I had our guy in Oakland, our video guy, make for me so I could go home and study it. And again, what I was fascinated with was Edgar's ability to drive the ball to the opposite field. So we could go ahead and run the tape right here. But
well, this is a great shot. That's a great
when
shot.
I came here, and look at the barrels burning, man.
That's a cool. Now that's cool.
They full blown light those on fire. So this is what I saw. Like, this is kind of your classic Edgar Martinez. And if you're at home, keep watching for a second because you're going to notice something over and over and over again. And then there's going to be a couple of guys, and it's right there. It's that back foot. And I didn't even know what to call it back when I originally watched it. And last year, I ended up doing a play ball segment with Jose Altuve. And the way the back foot slips back, it allows the front side to stay closed. So when I kept seeing this over and over and over again, I tried it. Well, guess what? Then all of a sudden, Miguel Cabrera comes around. Edgar, I'm like, this is the same thing. So then I go back and I'm studying tape of Miguel Cabrera. And again, look at the front hip, because when that back foot goes back and that stays closed, was this something that you worked on, or was that just natural for you?
I think for me, it came part natural. Actually, I repeat the same movement over and over again. It got better over time. And as I became aware that this was the best for me, the best approach, I just keep working on it.
I'm just looking at that back foot.
Watch.
And you said it moves back.
So Altuve actually said he watched Miguel Cabrera over and over and over again. And then he also referenced Edgar. And I imagine, again, this is not a natural movement for me. It was my first movement was hip flying open. That's why I could pull the baseball and hit the ball a long way that way, but I couldn't do it that way. And so when I saw his tape, the one thing I tried to do is I tried to get this movement, and as much as I worked on it, I couldn't perfect it. Jose Altuve said he watched this movement, and his whole thing, the way he sets up, the way he comes in, exactly where he's landing.
Look at that, right there.
Yep.
He works on this. He actually does this over and over again to really get that feeling down.
What drills or, you know, would you sort of use maybe in the offseason or certainly, you know, before the game to try to, you know, repeat that motion? Yeah.
There is a drill that actually Mike Zunino is doing right now.
Can you show us?
Yes. And he stands basically in a normal position from the plate,
mm-hmm.
and the tee is a little higher, and he, as he hit the ball, he pushed the foot back.
So he's making a concerted effort to really push it back.
Yes, and he repeats the same motion over and over, so it becomes part of his normal swing over time. This type of drill, it has to be repeated every single day, and over time, it becomes part of your swing.
What was your mentality when you stepped in the box? What was your approach? What were you trying to do?
You know, the swing path was something that I work on. I wanted to make contact as square to the plate as possible and stay through the plate and stay in the zone as long as possible. So to do that, I have to work on my hands, have to be in position to get to this, the bat gets to this place over home plate. So I approach middle of the field, always middle of the field, I react outside and I react inside. As long as I don't overstride and my top half is not leaning over, I'm able to bring my hands in and stay behind the ball and use both sides of the field.
You told me earlier, you said the power comes from the legs.
Yes.
Are there drills that you would do with your load and your setup?
Yes. Now, I put the tee way in front, and I will swing, make contact, and stay true. The backside has to be released, because if you stay back, roll over, pull the ball. But I have to come up, come off the backside, land, hit, and come off the backside.
So you wanted this moving?
Yes.
That's the
only way the bat can stay through the zone. If you stay back, this is what happened. Roll over.
Wow.
I know. I mean, it's fascinating. All the little details. Great stuff. Great stuff. Seattle wraps up their series against the New York Yankees. Edgar, we appreciate the time. Thanks for joining us.
Thank
Good
you
luck
for
the rest
me.
Of the way.
Thank you.
Hopefully, Cooperstown comes calling sometime very soon. Thanks again for joining us.
Thank you.